Meanwhile, out-of-control bushfires are right now burning in Victoria's west. Let's bring in senior meteorologist Miriam Bradbury at the Bureau of Meteorology. Thanks for being with us. What are the conditions right now and which areas are affected?
Well, particularly regarding those bushfires ongoing in the west, we do actually have a high fire danger today. Compare that to catastrophic yesterday. That was when we were seeing the worst weather conditions for fire danger. They're very, very hot conditions, the strong northerly winds. We've shifted behind the front now, so it's a bit cooler. The winds aren't quite as strong, but we do still have high fire dangers out. And really, that's just a testament to how difficult the conditions still are. They're certainly better than yesterday. It will be cooler today with the winds not as strong, but still the impacts will be ongoing over the coming days, particularly in those areas where the fires are still burning.
Miriam, can you give us an indication of the conditions that led to that destruction throughout Melbourne yesterday?
Yeah, well, essentially we had very warm, windy conditions ahead of a strong cold front. Now, the warm weather can often generate thunderstorms through the afternoon and evening, particularly ahead of a cold front where the atmosphere is what we like to call dynamic and unstable as well. Sometimes the storms can align along the cold front and become extremely dangerous and extremely powerful. And that is what we saw happening yesterday along that frontal line. That very strong band of storms developed. It was already windy and the storms added further to the winds, and that's really what led to the widespread impacts we're seeing across the Melbourne area today.
Okay, thanks for being with us, Miriam. Several bushfires are burning out of control in the state's west, with one at emergency level this morning. Let's go live now to Nine's Amber Johnston, who's at a relief centre in Stawell. Amber, many people were left with nowhere to sleep last night.
They were. The issue yesterday is that the fire just changed so quickly, leaving locals mostly in a small township called Pomona just a moment's notice to pack up their bags and leave before it was too late. Most have come down to the evacuation centre behind me here in Stawell, and now this morning the nervous wait to find out if their homes are still standing. We do know that a number of properties were lost yesterday. Early reports this morning are suggesting upwards of 30 properties have been lost, with one local telling me that the historic church in the town of Pomona was also gutted in the blaze. We'll put up on the screen now other evacuation centres around the area if anyone needs somewhere to stay. Thankfully, a number of the fire warnings around the Grampians National Park have been reduced this morning, but also this morning news that five firefighters were injured fighting the blaze yesterday. They were trying to protect a home near Pomona where they were boxed in by the fire, that sudden change, and they were left with nowhere to go but to bunker down in their truck as that blaze rolled over. So terrifying conditions. These are experienced firefighters who are trained for this, but that even goes to show that even they are up against some pretty tough conditions. Thankfully, they are okay, understandably rattled, the same as locals. We were in the fire zone yesterday. Here is what one local had to say.
We're just out here just putting sprinklers around and haven't packed. Wasn't so much of a worry today, and then got, oh yeah, you better leave. So we started evacuating, and then I said, no, seriously, get out.
It is a lot calmer here this morning compared to yesterday, where crews were up against catastrophic fire conditions, the worst we've seen in 4 years since the devastating Black Summer bushfires. They are hoping for a bit of a break this morning so they can get on top of those blazes in the Grampians National Park and, more importantly, get in and assess the damage and get a better idea of exactly how many homes have been lost.
Okay, Amber Johnston there in store for us this morning. Thank you.
Out of control bushfire in Victoria has injured five firefighters and destroyed properties in Grampians National Park. Residents told it's too late to leave. Northern Grampians Mayor Rob Haswell joins us now. Rob, good morning to you. Gee, a hell of a 24 hours for you guys. How are you holding up?
Well, not too bad, thanks, Carl. Good morning.
Yeah, look, talk us through the damage so far and your areas of concern.
The damage I can talk about so far is I haven't been brought up to date this morning. I know there have been properties lost, there have been stock losses, there would have been wildlife that's been affected. Agriculture Victoria will be involved. But what I can talk to you about, Carl, is the emergency relief centre that we've opened here in the township of Stawell.
Okay, talk to me about how many people you're likely to see there. I mean, this is a tough fire to fight.
I called in there yesterday afternoon at about 5:30, and there were over 100 people. Since then, there've been a lot more. We've had over 150 people with around 40 to 50 staying there overnight. The rest of them, of course, were able to stay with family and friends or found accommodation elsewhere. But we had Victoria Police involved helping us, the Red Cross. It's been a total success, and everything we can possibly do to help the residents that are under stress.
Just looking at those pictures, I mean, it is kind of frightening. And when you look at the terrain, first of all, that firefighters have to navigate in order to get to the flames, accessible only by air in some of these parts, and that's difficult flying. Also, when you see the smoke almost at right angles to the ground, you know how fast the wind's blowing. Incredibly dangerous situation for residents.
It certainly was, and it all happened really quickly. It was something that this was the common thing amongst the people that I spoke to yesterday at the relief centre, was that it happened so quickly they were in a state of shock. Mm. It's one of those things. It was the ideal day yesterday to have a catastrophe. It was temperatures in the high 30s and very, very high winds.
Look, you're made of the tough stuff there, and we appreciate you being on today. You're going to need all of that in the coming days. Appreciate your time so much, Mayor.
Thanks so much.
Sarah.